Harris was scheduled to appear in Detroit tonight, but there's a problem. Paula Tubman's live.
One person is dead and four others injured in a crash following a high-speed police chase in Port Huron. It happened about 8:30 this morning at the corner of Dove and 24th Streets. Police say a white Chevy Camaro was driving erratically and took off as the patrol car turned around. The vehicle slammed into an SUV and two other cars were subsequently hit. A 49-year-old woman died at the scene. Four others were taken to the hospital. That crash is under investigation at this hour. We're going to take a closer look exactly at what happened. We'll have that report at 6. MGM Grand Casino and Hotel in Detroit has reopened after evacuating for a fire this morning. That was the scene earlier. Preliminary investigation showed the fire started in the Palette Dining Studio, but we don't yet know exactly what caused the fire. The restaurant will remain closed until the cleanup is complete. Fortunately, no one was hurt. Today, we'll peek inside the Michigan Supreme Court as it hears two cases involving guns in school. The cases are very similar. School boards in Ann Arbor and Clio Township enacted firearm bans on school property. In both cases, parents with concealed pistol permits who brought guns to schools were told to leave. The court is considering whether school districts can trump state law with their own gun restrictions. Rod Maloney is inside that hearing right now, and we will hear some of those arguments tonight at 5. Flint residents are not convinced their water is safe, and they rallied in Lansing to send a strong message. Activists are outraged over the state's decision to end distribution of bottled water in Flint. They are also calling for a boycott of Nestle products after the Snyder administration approved a permit allowing Nestle to extract 576,000 gallons of water every day. Snyder approved that permit the same week he ended bottled water distribution. Governor Snyder says 2 years of testing shows lead levels meet federal safety standards. Taking off first at 4, volunteers are standing by to take calls about any consumer problems your family is facing or problems in your neighborhood. Call 313-298-WDIV from now until 6:30, and we will hear from Hank in just a few minutes about this push to help you or someone you know. The warm-up we have been waiting for is finally moving into Metro Detroit, but there is a catch. Let's check in with Ben Bailey for the first forecast.
There's always a catch, but, you know, considering where we've been in the last couple of days, it's all an improvement a little earlier in the week. Look at this. We have ease out there right now, and this is despite the fact we didn't see a whole lot in the way of sunshine today, maybe a couple breaks here and there. Winds are on the light side, but there are some showers of rain, not snow. We're done with that, at least for the short term. You can see that's mostly south of Detroit headed out